Let's check on European markets first. They are mostly lower after the series of central bank decisions from London to Norway Thursday signaled a higher for longer rate environment. Investors in the region also parsing through a raft of economic data releases. That includes Spain's GDP grew faster than expected in the second quarter, while shrinking German business activity points to a contraction in the third quarter. As for Wall Street, futures are pointing to a rebound for the major U.S. indices after Thursday's sharp sell-off. But the S&P 500 and the Nasdaq are still headed for their worst weekly performance since March.
And here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Microsoft. That's after British regulators said Microsoft's restructured acquisition of Activision Blizzard opens the door to the deal being cleared. This sent the tech giant shares to rise 0.3% in pre-market trading. Also in focus, shares of Fox Corp after Rupert Murdoch announced that he's stepping down as chairman of the media giant, handing the reins to his son. Fox Corp shares will kick off trading at $32.14 apiece. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Qualcomm. The chipmaker confirmed Friday it has initiated a workforce reduction at its Shanghai and Taiwan offices in response to economic uncertainties and deteriorating U.S.-China relations. Qualcomm shares are up 0.5% before the bell.
Asian markets ended Friday trade on a mixed note in a week marked by interest rate decisions. The Nikkei 225 shed 0.5%, even as the Bank of Japan left its benchmark rate unchanged. Now, this is as the country's August inflation data showed the consumer price index remained above the bank's 2% target at 3.2%. Private sector activity there also expanded at its slowest rate since February. Meanwhile, Chinese markets surged following a report by Bloomberg. Regulators are considering lifting limits on share ownership by foreigners. As for the ASX 200, it eked out a gain, helping reverse losses for Australia, a 6.5% jump in shares of Costa Group, the country's biggest fruit and vegetable company. That's after its board accepted a $963 million takeover offer from a consortium led by U.S. private equity firm Payne Schwartz. Here at home, Philippine shares picked up gains, with the main index climbing for a second day to post a weekly gain. But at least one analyst sees more sell-off ahead, citing uncertainty in domestic economic conditions.
I am open to the possibility that we could still test lower lows. That could be exaggeration from lower liquidity, lower volumes in the market. And at the same time, you know, we still have some index stocks that haven't actually gone down. There is still largely that uncertainty that has been pervasive in the year. At the same time, though, we are already seeing the trend going down for inflation. Core inflation is telling you a lot more, rather than headline inflation. The BSP is still confident about the 2-4% target. And along with this, we have international targets, international agencies also telling us that, you know, our growth looks intact. We even got that upgrade in outlook, in rating. So at this point, we think that the market should be aware of the uncertainty and know the risks when getting into the market today. At the same time, we highly encourage everyone to look at the medium term and long term outlook that is quite positive if you take a look at the macro view.
The European Union pushes for increased global financing to address the world's challenges. EU President Charles Michel made the statement during the 78th United Nations General Assembly. In his speech, Michel cited the struggles of vulnerable economies who were impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic and Russia's war in Ukraine. He said debt servicing has caused 165 million individuals worldwide to experience poverty. Michel urged the Assembly to pursue a financial shakeup so countries can have better access to financing and reduce the risk of a debt crisis.
Il s'agit de rendre le système
financier. We cannot allow ourselves the luxury of one more debate about the increase in the amount of handouts. It's not a question of begging. It's a question of justice. What we are talking about here is making the global financial system more robust, fairer, and better prepared for the challenges of this century. Reallocation of $100 billion in special drawing rights is an important step. But we know it's not enough. We need to do more.
Et enfin, l'Union européenne est engagée.